Welcome to a special edition of The List. We honor our heroes for their service. A salute to vets.
Look at this guy.
Check out businesses offering great savings.
They might not advertise it very widely.
Plus, tap into veteran-owned craft breweries.
Impact as many veteran communities as we possibly can.
Then, find ways to support our heroes and their families.
Give kids the opportunity to go plant flags.
But first, a surprising Furry Pow Foundation.
It's like a new friendship blossoming.
That's at the top of our list right now.
Hey everyone, I'm Shaguna Dulo.
And I'm Christina Guerrero, and it's Veterans Day. And to honor these brave men and women, we are doing a show that's our Salute to Vets, where we highlight their lives and achievements.
For starters, we talk to a veteran who's continuing to serve by matching other vets with animals he rescues and who in turn rescue them.
That's right, the Vet Friends Foundation is our featured story at the top of the list.
This is a typical morning for Joel Rocky.
I'm taking care of like 20 senior dogs like this right here, and they keep me on my toes.
Joel served as a Navy corpsman with the 2nd Battalion, 9th Marines. And now he runs the Vet Friends Foundation.
So the Vet Friends Foundation is actually an organization that we started about 5 years ago, me and some of my buddies from the military. And it was an organization to kind of find service to self through service to others, which happens to be animals. More specifically, senior pets. They're growing off back here.
The foundation focuses on rescuing senior dogs and pairing them with vets to live out the rest of their lives. Joel says he started the organization because he wanted to continue to serve.
There was a lot of organizations out there to help veterans in different ways, but there wasn't a lot that were helping veterans and like, hey, we want you to continue to serve and bring value into your life.
Look at this guy.
Joel says that when he left the military, he struggled to find his next step, but he knew he wanted to continue to give back and serve his community.
And I realized that I can't be the only one. There's got to be other veterans who are just kind of like, hey, I want to do something more.
The Vet Friends Foundation runs and operates out of Camp Golden Years in Tehachapi, California.
What's going on, dude?
Where senior dogs run, play, and live their best lives. But the main thing that happens here is the building of relationships. Joel says that many of the matches really save each other, like Vietnam vet Greg and his rescue dog Pops.
He just like loves this little dog so much. And those two get into all kinds of trouble together, but teaming them up was a huge thing because at that time, you know, Greg didn't have anybody in his life. He was an elderly gentleman living alone. And he didn't have anybody.
Now Greg not only has Pops, but he also has a family that he never expected to have.
And because of that, he has a whole group of people back in Michigan that help him out, take him to his doctor's appointments. I mean, he does more things than I do. He's very active now. He'll go garage sailing, he'll go to the thrift shops. I mean, he's a party animal. And Pops is always along there with him.
And the best benefit of the Vet Friends Foundation, it teaches everyone involved to just enjoy life.
By the nature of senior dogs, it seems like we do get a lot of people who are a little older as well. As we get older, we're not as social. We do lose some friends, we lose touch with people. And when someone steps inside and finds a little dog that they're gonna take home, it's like a new friendship blossoming.
Joel says that it affects both sides of the relationship. It gives veterans a chance to save yet another life, and it gives senior dogs a second chance at life.
Even if it is rescuing a little dog, like, there it is, you know, it's just a beautiful thing to see.
We salute you, veterans, and we are celebrating the Vet Friends Foundation at the top of the list.
Today, we're celebrating the brave men and women of the U.S. military for their service. So if you're looking to really show your appreciation, Heidi Fogel's song has some great ways to honor them.
Today we honor America's veterans for keeping our nation the land of the free and home of the brave.
Veterans Day gives everybody a great opportunity to just take one day and go in and learn about the tremendous sacrifice that these people make and that this freedom that everybody has, it's not free.
So to learn about a few ways we can celebrate our veterans, we turn to John Greenway, founder of Mission 2 Alpha, a nonprofit that raises money and awareness for the needs of injured military and first responder heroes. First up, learn about Gold Star families.
When you think about Veterans Day, the natural inclination, right, is to just think about those people that have served. What a lot of people don't think about are the families that are left behind. And those families are called Gold Star families.
And John recommends that we
Google Gold Star families, and there's just all kinds of reference material that can teach you about them. If you contact any veterans group, they usually have some type of event or something where they're supporting these families in some way.
Next up, gather the family and watch a military movie or series.
I think movie nights are a great opportunity for people to be entertained, but they will also learn a tremendous amount.
He recommends
The Pacific and Band of Brothers and 1917. One of my favorites is Taking Chance, which is all about a Marine. They're pretty realistic, and you can't help feel a tremendous patriotism and sense of pride when you watch those movies, but also you get a real feeling for the loss and the tragedy that comes with war.
Finally, plan a trip to a veteran's cemetery.
Obviously, a cemetery is not the happiest place that you can go, but it's sacred ground.
And he says before you go, try the cemetery site to look up names of people that are there.
And to give kids the opportunity to go plant flags, they'll have fun. But when you combine that with learning about the people that are there, I think they learned something that is priceless.
Thank you to all the men and women who have sacrificed for us. Happy Veterans Day.
While today is set aside to honor our veterans, Jimmy Rhodes says many businesses show them gratitude year round by offering some great savings. Hey Jimmy, what's the deal?
Veterans Day sales are just for one weekend, but
you can find veterans discounts any time of year.
Julie Ramhold from DealNews.com researched discounts available to veterans all year long. So we're picking her brain while it's at peak freshness. The first thing you need to know, veterans discounts are sometimes kind of secret.
They might not advertise it very widely. It just kind of depends.
So look for lists of products and stores that offer discounts. At DealNews,
we have a list of over 150 military discounts.
And most military discounts will also work for veterans.
Any place that offers a military discount, often they extend it to other statuses as well as to veterans.
And this is kind of weird. The discounts can vary by location.
Most of the time, these places that have individual owners or are franchises, it's kind of left up to them because sometimes they want to give something like 10%. Other places, especially if they're in like a military-centric area, they may offer even more. So it really just depends.
So if you're grabbing lunch at a chain,
the same chain across town may not offer the same discount. So just be aware that things like that can change.
Which means most times you've just got to ask.
Ask everybody and be nice about it. People are weird sometimes about discounts, no matter who they're for. So just inquire politely. And odds are, you know, if they have one, they'll walk you through it.
And for the same reason you aren't sure, whoever's working that shift might not be sure either.
If you get a no, that doesn't necessarily mean that it is a no, especially if it's not widely advertised.
So do your research before you make a trip.
Definitely make the call before you head out to a store. If you're looking to place an order online, email their customer service, call their customer service hotline, something like that.
Next, military and veteran discounts often extend to families.
They can shop for other people besides themselves. They can shop for family members. They can shop for grandkids. And in some cases, those military discounts will actually extend to spouses and children of the veteran or the active military member.
Finally, just like the military itself, there will be protocols.
I suggest having a military ID on hand. If you're shopping online, there are programs like ID.me and Sheer ID. You can go through them. It's a third party, and they usually just have you enter your information, and it verifies it for the store.
Saluting service with discounts is what's the deal.
Honoring Veterans Day continues next. Supporting heroes through suds and ciders.
Their patch kind of resembles a strawberry.
Plus, helping vets with virtual reality, cooking, and horses.
I've seen veterans cry and they come out feeling a lot more relief.
Then they entertained us on the screen and they served our country. Our Salute to Vets continues next.
Welcome back to our Salute to Vets show. Most of our veterans leave the service with incredible life experience and skill sets. And luckily for beer lovers, we've mustered three veterans that decided craft beer was their mission in civilian life.
The discipline and tenacity of serving in the military equips veterans for almost any line of work you can imagine. And on Veterans Day, we salute the brave men and women who tapped into their military skill sets and opened up craft breweries. We'll start with Cider Corps in Phoenix, Arizona, which started when Marine Corps veteran Jason Duren used cider making as a form of therapy after he left the Marines wounded with a traumatic brain injury.
Cider making process was very therapeutic for me. It gave me something that, you know, many nights, it's hours of working on something.
With the help of his brother and co-owner, Josh, the duo specialized in making military unit-themed ciders like Tropic Lightning. An ode to the U.S. Army's legendary 25th Infantry Division located in Hawaii.
Their patch kind of resembles a strawberry. This is our base cider with strawberry, and then it also has hibiscus, which is kind of like a play for Hawaii.
They make several other all-natural flavors that you can even purchase online, and veterans get a 10% discount.
I served for 8 years active duty. Went to Iraq in April of 2003. And I was responsible for the lives of over 300 people.
Marching to our second spot is Service Brewing Company in Savannah, Georgia.
I went to YouTube University and started learning how to brew.
West Point grad and Army Commander Kevin Ryan and his partner Meredith Sutton started it to craft great beer and help veterans returning home.
Craft beer is very task-oriented. It's physically demanding. So hiring veterans is giving them an opportunity to continue to be active, but also it helps with their transition into civilian life.
For now, Service Brewing beers are only available in their Savannah tasting room. We're marching forward with Backward Flag Brewing Company, which wraps our list.
The Backward Flag for us is a symbol of service and patriotism.
U.S. Army veteran Tori Fisher named her brewery for the way the Army wears their flag patch on their right shoulder.
The Backward Flag on the battlefield and moving forward into the fight.
After Tori's two tours in Iraq, she opened the brewery with an equally important mission.
It's definitely to support and impact as many veteran communities as we possibly can.
You can find Backward Flag in their tap room and stores throughout New Jersey. From the battlefield to the brew house, we're raising a can to veteran-owned breweries.
Well, after valiantly serving our country, veterans often need a little help readjusting to civilian life. So Teresa Strasser has three programs supporting former servicemen and women on the Buzz List. Teresa.
Thanks. These great programs help veterans after their time serving in the military. First, Horses for Heroes is a Las Vegas-based nonprofit dedicated to giving veterans and their families deep discounts on morale-boosting equestrian activities. Their network has over 300 facilities across the U.S. and Canada, and programs like Operation Free Ride have given thousands of free horseback rides to help our heroes transition to life back home.
I've seen veterans cry and I wouldn't say break down, but they have that moment and they're just expunging everything, right? That they can't tell their wife, that they can't tell therapists, and they come out feeling a lot more relieved.
Those horses really are like four-legged therapists. Next, the Tennessee State Veterans Home is just one of many places using virtual reality headsets from the company MindVR to give aging vets some cool experiences. There are hundreds of videos vets can choose from, like flying a jet, being on a Broadway stage, and even just playing with puppies.
Oh, there's the puppy. Hey, Tweety Pie. Come on, get on my lap.
Oh, I love the animals. The little puppies are so cute.
That was wonderful, really wonderful. And I enjoyed the airplane ride and landing on a deck. Animals, it's a fascinating thing.
Vets, jets, and pets. Now that is an unbeatable trio. And the third hero helping program making our list, the Culinary Institute of America, which was founded in 1946 to prepare World War II vets for careers in the food industry, is still going strong. They have three locations in the U.S., one in Singapore, and now veterans who qualify can get up to 100% of their tuition paid for.
You know, you've got someone who's spent typically a great deal of time being organized and regimented, and cooking is regimented, it's organized.
Hey, when you hear about a kitchen run with military precision, that is a good thing. Programs helping our heroes on the Buzz List. We've got lots more to come. Stay with us.
Welcome back to our Salute to Vet show. Today, we're taking a few minutes to highlight some of the best movies honoring the courageous men and women who have served our country. Our picks to watch are on the hot list.
Veterans Day is a holiday to honor those who've served in the U.S. Armed Forces. And throughout cinematic history, we've seen them honored time and time again.
I have my hands, my eyes, my ears.
We're highlighting four of the most critically acclaimed examples of this, starting all the way back in 1946 with The Best Years of Our Lives.
I love you.
This film has a 97% critic score on Rotten Tomatoes, won 7 Oscars, including Best Picture, and became the highest-grossing movie in the U.S. and U.K. since Gone with the Wind came out 8 years prior.
Wow.
It's about 3 servicemen struggling to readjust to civilian life after World War II.
There's nothing to be afraid of.
Now, let's fast forward to 1989 to check out Born on the 4th of July.
There is nothing prouder as a United States Marine.
Tom Cruise stars as Ron Kovic in this film about his journey from serving in Vietnam to becoming an anti-war activist.
Plans for the future?
I need your help.
Yes, we'll see.
Directed and co-written by fellow Vietnam vet Oliver Stone, it ended up getting Stone a Best Director Oscar and won the Golden Globe for Best Dramatic Motion Picture.
I'm home.
And from the 80s, we go to the 90s with Saving Private Ryan.
We got him.
Steven Spielberg's 1998 film, starring Tom Hanks and Matt Damon, gives you a front row seat at D-Day and the Battle of Normandy. It has stellar reviews on Rotten Tomatoes, was the highest grossing movie of the year, and won 5 Oscars, not to mention Best Dramatic Motion Picture at the Golden Globes.
If that earns me the right to get back to my wife, well then that's my mission.
And let's wrap things up with the most recent film on our list celebrating the bravery of our veterans, The Hurt Locker.
You realize every time you suit up, it's life or death.
Jeremy Renner stars in this 2008 Iraq war film that has an incredible 97% critic rating on Rotten Tomatoes and won 6 Oscars, becoming the only Best Picture winner to be directed by a woman, Kathryn Bigelow.
That was good.
Movies honoring those who've served in the U.S. Armed Forces on the hot list.
Next, we go from movies about veterans to celebrities who have served our country. That's coming up.
Welcome back to our Salute to Vets show. Hollywood is known for the glitz and glam, but before some of our favorite stars walked the red carpet, they were marching in formation. Teresa Strasser has 3 celebrities who went from serving the Stars and Stripes to becoming stars themselves.
Every year on Veterans Day, we honor those heroes who served our country. Among them, some very familiar faces. Here are 3 celebrities you may not know served in the military. First, Bea Arthur.
Now you can call him garbage.
We all loved Bea as sarcastic and feisty Dorothy on The Golden Girls, but before becoming an Emmy Award-winning actress, she was a Marine.
Welcome to my life.
The Golden Girl star was one of the first members of the Marine Corps Women's Reserve. She enlisted at only 21 years old and served as a typist and truck driver.
I thought you might want to hear about it.
You've misjudged me.
Arthur ultimately worked her way up to a staff sergeant and was honorably discharged in 1945. She passed away in 2009 at the age of 86. Next, Ice-T.
10 years ago, I used to listen to rapper flow.
From legendary rapper to famous actor. But before all the glitz and glam, he joined the Army as a way to support his then-girlfriend and daughter.
I got to do something responsible. So I went in the Army, I went down, and I just signed up.
He served for 4 years and was a squad leader at Schofield Barracks based in Hawaii.
I'm the illest, bulletproof. I die harder than Bruce Willis.
Lastly, Adam Driver.
G-Mar!
Charlie Bird!
You may know him from movies like Marriage Story on Netflix or Star Wars. He plays Kylo Ren. At the age of 18, Adam joined the U.S. Marine Corps as a way to serve his country in the wake of the 9/11 attacks. He spent over 2 years as an infantry Marine, but then suffered a mountain biking accident before being deployed.
But then being told I wasn't going to deploy to Iraq or Afghanistan was very devastating for me.
He ultimately got into Juilliard and began his acting career. He's also formed Arts in the Armed Forces, a theater company that performs for troops all over the world.
I can think of no better community to arm with a new means of self-expression than those protecting our country.
Veteran heroes turned Hollywood stars, three celebrities who served.
Christina, I never had a clue any of them were in the military. Quite impressive.
Yes, well, thanks to them and to all of our other veterans. And thanks to you for watching our special Salute to Vets show.